video from the 2009 Hula Ho'olauna Aloha, the ninth annual event that unites Japan and Hawaii in celebration in Hula. And it goes down this Saturday at Ala Moana Center Stage and Sunday at the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. And here to tell us about this unique event is one of the judges, Kumu Blaine Kia. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Before we talk about the event, I wanted to talk about really quickly, there's a huge controversy in the hula world right now. Grant is out there now to establish basically an online class and another type of class to become a kumu hula, which is a teacher of hula.
Correct.
And it's a controversy among many kumu hula. Why is that?
Well, first of all, to become a kumu hula, the uniki process, so the process of graduating into that particular rank, is quite sacred and spiritual and traditional for many of our Hawaiians who practice it. It can take many, many years to become one. And many of us who live here who have been a part of the uniki process, it's quite different in terms of how it's being treated today in technology, with having the web, of having internet and having different ways to use hula now in the culture as a commodity.
Right.
Many of us are trying many ways to make ends meet and are getting quite creative. And so depending on what side you're on, there are a lot of controversies surrounding that particular program or programs that are out there that might not agree with most Hawaiians.
Right. So it sounds like a non-traditional type of school, like you could take online courses to become a kumu hula. And so you are against this then?
And not so much against it, but the application of it, it is questionable because some of us who have gone through the uniki process, we've gone through so many different aspects of that process. And to do it online or to do it in a different process of a grant, it just depends on who the kumu hula is, what they have to offer, and the length of time in which this deep, sacred tradition is taught and applied.
Really quickly, moving on to the festival, a lot of Japanese people here to participate. Why does Japan love hula so much?
They love, you know, it's been over 40 years that Japan has adopted hula, and they've adopted it for social reasons, for hobbies, or whatever it may be. In the last 10 or 15 years, they have now begin to learn and understand it from a very traditional perspective. So they come to the Hula Ho'olauna, which is a social assembly of the Japanese people, in order for us to nurture them in a nurturing environment, and having two different kinds of formats, the exhibition at Ala Moana Center, then having the competition on Sunday the 11th, and then on Monday the 12th, we take them through a series of workshops, and then we celebrate Monday night. So we do put them through this process of in a nurturing environment.
All right, Blaine Kia, thank you so much for joining us. I really appreciate it. Thanks so much for talking
Mahalo.
With us about some of these issues.
All right.
And we'll be right back after the break. The time now is 6:15.